Hello everyone, it's me, Joe McKay, on my very own takeover day. I decided to wait till today to announce the kit that I'll be making for the Great Bead Extravaganza Fall Fest coming up soon. I'll be on Saturday, October the 21st at 12:30 Mountain Time. There'll be lots of posts with all the different times and zones, which is too much for me. And some other people too. Nile comes to mind. Anyways, I hope you're having a great day. I want to, I really am excited because you can use today's coupon, which is TOD15 at the shop, and you can use it on my TGBE kit. And the name of the kit is the Hearts Renewal Talisman Necklace Kit. And I have personally been struggling some emotionally because of some difficult things going on. And I know it seems like since COVID hit that most people are struggling more than they did prior to that, or perhaps it just was so much more added on top of what we usually deal with, it just seems like more now. But whatever the reason, I don't know if you know, but a good big part of my career has been spent using the arts to help people heal and to correct social situations that are unjust, unright. Most of you know that I worked with Mr. Rogers, Fred Rogers, of Mr. Robert Rogers' neighborhood, and we opened a grieving center for children and their families, and I helped create all of the curriculum for every age group. And then I had done that on a year-long grant, and when the grant ended, they didn't want me to leave, so I became a contractor for them. And I worked there and with every family that came through for 13 years. And it helped shape me into the person that I am today. It taught me what is really important, why, and I've been working on myself ever since. And I find it hugely important to spend time working on myself. Almost every day I do this. And it's just become part of my thought process now. How does this relate to my kit? Well, this kit is so different than anything I've ever tried before. Usually we're just making jewelry. But I want you to know that the art of jewelry making can transcend mere, aesthetics. Personally, I've spent years honing my craftsmanship and creating beautiful symbols and understanding that builds an intimate connection with the piece that you're making. And these become emotional symbols that we're going to wear. And in the jewelry realm, such a symbol is called a talisman. So a talisman is a piece of jewelry that's imbued with intentions, energies, to act as a touchstone to your deepest parts of yourself, to your heart of hearts. It is designed to be protective, bring good energy, luck, all of these things. And so it serves both as an aesthetic adornment, but also as a touchstone with more powerful metaphysical, components. So the pendant in my kit is a beautiful Tibetan, it's actually made to house a little Buddha, but I got a source that allowed me just to get the pendant without the Buddha, because I didn't want this attached to any particular, I didn't want it attached to any particular religion. This is really just about I'm trying to get to where the comments are in case somebody's making a comment. But this is really about your spiritual self, your whole self, taking care of yourself. And So in the kit, you're going to get many, many different gemstones. And why don't I just switch to my hands here and show you. You're going to get 2 full strands of this Amazonite. And then this is all knotted. But here is my talisman. And it is full of gemstones. And you see there's also a northern light or a compass. Either one or both. It's what that symbolizes. Everybody will get one of those. There's this little scroll. These are great. Just unwrap them and write something to yourself. And I'll help guide you with that. And then roll it back up and put it in your talisman. So that's very cool. But let's go through all the gemstones that you're going to be getting. Well, let's take a look at this locket first of all. It's just beautiful. And sometimes you need a little pin or a Zacto to get it started, to get it open. And then it just comes right open. So on the bottom, there's a little catch that you line up to close it back up. This is not glass. It's a very, very clear, high polished, it looks like glass, high polished plexiglass. So it's safe. This is all stainless with all these nice, beautiful, all the beautiful designs on it. And this is what you're going to put your gemstones and your keepsakes, your touchstones, anything you want. And what I've designed are questions. And each question, so you're going to get red jasper. You're going to get citrine. I'm not going to open each one. You're going to get rose quartz, sodalite, red and black fluorite, black onyx, color, the other colors of fluorite, peridot, a bag of quartz crystal points, terminated points, you get aquamarine, and you get apatite. Okay, so what I'm going to come back up here. What I want to say is that I have made up. So in my website, when you purchase this kit, you will need to scroll to the very bottom of, I want you to read the description, but scroll to the very bottom of the description, and there will be 2 links to 2 digital downloads that will cost you nothing. And you don't even have to buy the kit. You can just download these links if you want, because one of the links are a list of 15 personal questions. And these personal questions all list a corresponding gemstone as far as what that gemstone, you know, the spiritual properties of that gemstone are. So according to how the questions impact you and your answers, you can add more of what you think you need, whether it be rose quartz, tourmaline, peridot, whichever. But I wanted to read you the questions, because it was a great exercise. I have worked really hard on all of this. I'm inviting you into my own process here. And I do these kind of things all the time as far as making lists of questions that I need to answer for myself and really be honest with myself. So I thought I'd read them to you. And now that you know that this kit is about an introspective journey, right? So number 1 is called purpose and meaning. What is my true purpose in my life? Am I aligning my actions to fulfill it? If not, what is something more that I can do to bring more of my true purpose to life? And the corresponding gemstone for that is tourmaline. The second one falls under values. What do I most value in my life? Am I giving enough time and energy to what I value the most? These seem like pretty simple questions, but what I encourage you to do is to download these questions and have your answers filled out before my presentation. I'm going to go through them and give you my answers to these during the presentation to share with you. You don't have to share your answers with anyone, okay? So the third question is about self-acceptance. It says, which part of myself do I dislike? Why? How can I begin to love the parts of myself I may be denying, to embrace them more fully in order to love myself more fully? Those are pretty big questions, actually. So maybe there's three or four questions in each question. Hey, Susan, thanks for showing that you're here. So the fourth has to do with the past. I work a lot in this area. Do you have any unresolved experiences from your past that are affecting your present? And how can you work to reconcile these things within yourself? What small steps or large steps can you take? And what I want you to do is you print these questions out and then make a corresponding list with the numbers and write out as much as you need to or want to answering these questions in your own home or wherever you may be. And then once you're done, you can look back at your answers and see where you needed to write a lot more. That may be an indicator that maybe you should put more of that gemstone in order to be a touchstone for that very important part. And the past, so the corresponding gemstone for that is black onyx. The fifth question has to do with the future. What fears or anxieties do you hold about the future? Think of ways to address them in order to be more present. Yes, being present. When we're thinking about the future, we're generally not so present, right? So what is it that's worrying you and taking you out of the present? And how can you deal with it? What can you do to stay more present? This is why I love creating, and this is why creating has always been a huge tool in my life and in all of the sectors that I've worked in using the arts for healing. And I'm very proud to say in 2018, the entire creative industry awarded me with a humanitarian award for all the work that I have done to teach people how the arts can heal you, calm you, center you, bring you ease, and keep you in the present. Oops, sorry. Get rid of that. Anyways, so now I want to share it with you, okay? If you don't have any interest in this, you can skip my presentation. But I have a belief that even if you don't buy the kit, download the questions and just work through them. It's a great exercise for yourself. All right. The sixth question is about personal growth. In which area of your life do you feel like you might be or are stagnating? And what steps can you take to grow and evolve in these areas? Okay. Great question. And the corresponding gemstone for that is peridot. No, I had it wrong. That was the last one. Excuse me. That's crystal points. So the personal growth one are the terminated crystal points. Oh, good. Printed on both sides. I thought I skipped a page. So number seven question is about relationships. Do you have a current relationship? Do your current relationships uplift and support you, or do they drain you and diminish you? This is really important. I used to try and just love everyone, and I love everyone on a universal level, but when it comes down to one-on-one, it's very tricky. And I do know people that as soon as I'm with them, I just feel exhausted and drained, and I want to cover my belly because it hurts. And I think it's really important to listen to your body when it's trying to tell you. So how can you foster healthier relationships? You know, you can think of specific relationships. I have one in mind. I'll share that with you on the day of the presentation. But the corresponding gemstone for that is sodalite. Number 8 question is about boundaries. Where might you need to set stronger boundaries in your life? And how can you do so with love and assertiveness? And you can do it with both. So usually people think of love as being mild and timid, but sometimes love has to be strong and bold. And when you're fighting for your own sanity and your boundaries and you're trying to care for them and yourself, you need to be assertive at certain times, okay? And the corresponding gemstone for that is black onyx. Number 9 is about forgiveness. This one is really important. Who or what do I need to forgive, including yourself or myself, to release emotional burdens in order to make room for more joy, for more any positive thing, for more creating, for more community, more communing with your friends, your family? The corresponding gemstone for that is rose quartz. All right, now that number 10 question is about joy and passion. What truly brings you joy and passion, and how can you incorporate more of it into your daily life? Spend some time with that one, definitely. The corresponding gemstone for that is citrine. Number 11 is about self-love. And this one we all need a bunch of. I personally have unending, abounding amounts of self-loathing left over from my childhood. Oh my. But think of ways that you don't like yourself or things you don't like about yourself. And how can you show those parts more compassion daily, especially during challenging times? And during challenging times, I mean, you know, that can be as much as just being super stressed or facing surgery or going through surgery with a loved one. It can be the loss of a loved one. It can be many, many different things. You know, and even your body doesn't know the difference in good stress and bad stress. And even good stress is stress. Stress is really bad for you. But loving ourselves through these things, I mean, I don't know about you, but I am not as kind to myself as I am to everyone else. I'm pretty hard on myself, really. Very hard on myself. I've been working on this for years. Try to be more friendly to yourself. That's why at the end of almost every broadcast, I say be good to others and be kind to yourself. Yeah. So the number 12 question is about legacy. Okay. What kind of legacy do you want to leave behind? How can you start working towards it more each day? That's an interesting question that I don't think most people will ever ask themselves. I know some very talented, very professional musicians that think about that all the time, their musical legacy. What is your legacy? Is it your family? Is it what you do? Think about it. That goes right along with your purpose in this world. I think I made that one the first question, right? I think I did. Yep. Purpose and meaning was number 1. Okay, number 13 question is about intuition. I have a very strong sense of intuition. I have a very loud and clear inner voice. It used to be a little bit of a whisper, but now it's really growing. So I ask, do you pay attention to the little voice inside you? Is it a whisper or is it loud and clear? How can you better trust and listen more to your inner voice? It is a practice, just like paying attention is a practice. I simply try to be exactly where I'm at every step of my day. I try not to be up here thinking and thinking. I try to be aware where I'm at, what I'm doing, and keep it simple, because I really get stressed out. Okay, number 14 is about limiting beliefs. Can you identify any of your own your beliefs that you're holding on to that may be limiting your perspective? And how can they be reframed into empowering beliefs? Okay, it's a little spiritual journey. We are spiritual beings in a human body. That is truly what I believe. Our heart, we have many different kinds of intelligence. And our mind can really work against us. I mean, I used to do a workshop where with teenagers in particular, and would say a really wonderful sentence, and they would have to say that to themselves. And then they had to write down the response that their mind came up with. And most each and every one was so negative, it was so sad. And they were just like, whoa. I'm like, that is not you. That is a limiting belief. That's not you. You can rid yourself of those thoughts. You just got to do some battle with them. The last question is about contribution. How can I make a positive impact in the world, in your community, in your family, if even in small ways, to feel more connected to the larger whole? Okay? So, the idea here, when it comes to this kit, I'm going to show you how to do the knotting and all of that. But the main portion of this presentation will be me sharing my answers to those questions. And I really worked hard on, you know, giving you a corresponding gemstone to make it easier for you to fill your gemstone. Because once it's closed, it's closed. So, and if you don't feel like wearing it, you can hang it in your home where you can see it and let it be a touchstone for you. I think right this second I'm going to go to my website and pick out the link so you and put it in to the comments below. And I can also put in, so at the very bottom of the very bottom of the description are the two links, and I'm going to go ahead right now, and where did it go? I'm going to go back to DIY. Hold on. Personal questions. Okay, here you can go here. And you check out, it doesn't cost you anything for the questions. You check out and then you're sent a link and you can download the document, okay? So there is that. That's download number two. Download number one is all of the healing properties of the gemstones in full detail. So let me put this link in there as well. And then I will also put it in to the kits link in the TGBE group here. So it's up there with all the other kits from all the most wonderful presenters. I love our group. We have a great deal of fun. But anyways, I hope you like this concept, because frankly, I like having more in-depth processes that have more, I buy in more when it involves my heart and my mind. I'm very good at design. It's simple for me. I can say that. I'm okay with saying that. I didn't used to be, but I am now. So I hope that you'll think about purchasing a kit and working through the questions. and getting all your gemstones and joining me for the presentation when I do the Hearts Renewal Talisman Necklace Kit. Okay, guys, mwah! Don't forget, there's 15% off everything in the store right now. TOD, capital letters, TOD 15. That's the coupon code. All right, bye.